Anish, that's a really interesting name.
Yeah, it's written from India and, yeah, it means hero in Indian. So,
hero?
Yeah.
Have you turned into a bit of a property hero?
I'd like to think so, yeah.
So, how has our intrepid hero found his first foray into being a full-time developer?
So, a nice Lewisham flat with the potential to extend upwards. A good price, good location, an interesting one to go for. Let's see who agreed when it went under the hammer.
163. 163. 164. 164. 165. 165. 166. 167. 167. 168. 169. 169. 170, sir. 170. 171. 171, 172, 173, 173, 174, 174, 175, 175, 176. Might be a limit. Never stop on those numbers. 176, sir, sitting down, you've been a good bidder. 176, 177. Against you standing up. It's with a gentleman sitting down. Can't let him have it on that. 176 with a gentleman sitting down. 176 for the first. 176 for the second. 176,000 for the third and final time.
In the end, that successful bidder was Anish, who paid 176,000. He's been developing properties since he was just 21. Up until now, he's had a full-time job as a business development manager in a retail business, but recently that all changed. I met up with him back at his new flat to find out more.
Anish, great to meet you.
Yeah, likewise.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Anish, that's a really interesting name.
Yeah, it's written from India and... Yeah, it means hero in Indian. So,
hero?
Yeah.
Fantastic. So, have you turned into a bit of a property hero?
I'd like to think so, yeah. We've recently just sort of given up the day job and going to go into property development sort of full-time.
So, what kind of thing have you been working on? What kind of projects have you done so far?
Yeah, we've done sort of generally residential houses, four refurbs and extensions as well. So, we've sort of added value that way.
Who's we?
Me and my wife.
Right.
Yes, Tinder.
Oh, great. So that's it's a partnership.
She's going to continue working.
Right.
So she's got the short straw.
What does she do?
She's a store manager.
Anish and Satinder plan to buy four properties a year and set up a property management company. You have to admire his courage. He's certainly living up to his name.
I can be your hero, baby. I can kiss away the pain.
So, would this be a tale of heroic triumph or a tragedy of noble failure? 1 month later, we're back. So, how has our intrepid hero found his first foray into being a full-time developer?
This was sort of my first professional property in terms of being off work. It's been much easier to manage being off work and being here on site every day to answer any kind of queries. So, from that side, it's been very successful and hopefully have many more to come.
Anish had been planning on putting this property up for rent. To keep costs to a minimum, he hoped to salvage as much as he could.
We've made good the wallpaper that was here, and we've got rid of any kind of seams, given it a good double coat of paint. We've kept the existing kitchen units as is, and we've replaced the worktops with a brand new worktop. We've got rid of the old white cooker, and we've replaced it with a built-in electric oven and a gas hob on top. On top of that, we've also put in the combi boiler, so we've kept that in its existing position. On top of that, we've also put in a brand new sink just to sort of finish off the apartment, and we've kept the existing tiles as well. I think it's just given it a good freshen up look.
This investment was Anish's first as a full-time developer, and it's been a great success, and he's already on to the next one.
We've secured another property, and it's a three-bedroom house. needs full refurbishment, so there's a lot more work to be done. But looking forward to it.